Let's compare Windows 10 May 2021 update with Windows 11 leak build 21996.1. On the left we have Windows 10 May 2021 update which was released on the 18th of May 2021 and on the right we have Windows 11 build 21996.1 which was compiled on the 29th of May 2021 and leaked on the 15th of June 2021. In Windows 10 we have the Windows 10 logo on a blue background and on Windows 11 we have some blue wavy things. Let's compare the skin. In Windows 10 the window corners are square, in Windows 11 the window corners are rounded. In Windows 10 the menus have square corners, a gray background and a blue highlight. In Windows 11 the menus have rounded corners, a white background and a gray highlight. They also have more of a shadow than they do in Windows 10. In Windows 10 the checkboxes are square and are white with a black tick, in Windows 11 they are rounded and blue with a white tick. In Windows 10 the buttons are gray and square, in Windows 11 they are white and rounded. In Windows 11 the scroll bars have also been updated. In Windows 11 when you hold the mouse over the maximize button it gives you some snapping options. In Windows 10 it does not. In Windows 10 when you drag a window to the side or to the top it gives you a faint outline. In Windows 11 it gives you a blurry outline. In Windows 11 you can snap the screen in 3, in Windows 10 you can only snap the screen in 2 or 4. In Windows 11 when you have multiple windows stacked, that group shows up above the taskbar when you put the mouse over any of the windows in that group. In Windows 10 it does not. In Windows 10 when in portrait the windows still snap to the sides of the screen, in Windows 11 when in portrait the windows snap to the top and bottom of the screen. Let's compare the taskbar. In Windows 10 the taskbar is dark by default, in Windows 11 it is light by default, although this can be changed in both. In Windows 10 the icons on the taskbar are left aligned, in Windows 11 they are centered by default but can be left aligned. In Windows 11 the taskbar is thicker than it is in Windows 10. In Windows 10 Cortana is on the taskbar, in Windows 11 it is not. In Windows 11 it shows the weekday on the taskbar, in Windows 10 it does not. Although you can get the weekday on the taskbar in Windows 10 by making the taskbar thicker. In Windows 10 when you right-click the taskbar you get heaps of options, in Windows 11 you only get taskbar settings. In Windows 10 the search can either be hidden, an icon or a box. In Windows 11 it cannot be a box. In Windows 10 the start button is 4 solid white boxes slanted at an angle, in Windows 11 it is 4 blue boxes not at an angle and it is shaded. Let's compare the start menu. In Windows 10 the pinned apps are on tiles at the right, in Windows 11 the pinned apps are icons at the top and it has recommended below. In Windows 10 the All Apps list is on the left, in Windows 11 you have to click All Apps. In Windows 10 the Power and Account are at the left, in Windows 11 they are at the bottom. In Windows 10 when you show folders on Start they are at the left, in Windows 11 they are at the bottom. In Windows 10 you can name groups of tiles and you can drag them around, in Windows 11 you can have multiple pages of pinned apps. In Windows 10 you can resize the Start menu. In Windows 11 you cannot. In Windows 10 you can arrange tiles into folders, in Windows 11 you can move the icons around. In Windows 10 the start menu has square corners and touches the taskbar, in Windows 11 it has rounded corners and floats. In Windows 10 when you hover over items in the apps list there is a glow that follows the mouse, in Windows 11 there is not. In Windows 10 the UWP apps are loose in the apps view and the classic apps are in folders. In Windows 11 the only folder is Windows Ease of Access, some of the classic apps such as File Explorer, Notepad and Paint are now loose in the apps view, the rest of the classic apps such as WordPad are now under Windows Tools which opens in a window. In Windows 11 Notepad and Paint now have new icons, although the programs themselves look the same. Windows Security and Settings also have new icons. Some of the icons in the Settings app have also been updated. The folder icons in the File Explorer have also been updated. In Windows 11 items viewed in Details view are now more spaced apart. In Windows 11 the icons for the different view options in the File Explorer have also been updated. In Windows 10 the Recycle Bin icon is side on, in Windows 11 it is front on. Same with the Drive icon and the Windows logo. In Windows 10 the search bar is at the bottom, in Windows 11 it is at the top. In Windows 11 there is now a Widgets dashboard. In Windows 10 in Task view it shows your running programs and gives you a timeline and the desktops are at the top. In Windows 11 it does not give you a timeline and the desktops are at the bottom. In Windows 10 the Alt plus Tab switcher has a black box around it. In Windows 11 the Alt plus Tab switcher makes the rest of the screen go dark. In Windows 10 you can have the taskbar at the bottom, at the side or at the top. In Windows 11 the taskbar can only be at the bottom. In Windows 10 you can make the taskbar show labels, combine only one taskbar is full and use small icons like it is in Windows XP and Vista. In Windows 11 you cannot. In Windows 10 you can change the taskbar height and have folder toolbars, in Windows 11 you cannot. In Windows 10 the menu that you get when you right-click the start button or press Windows key X is solid and has square corners, in Windows 11 it is frosted glass and has round corners. In Windows 10 Internet Explorer is still present, in Windows 11 it has been removed. In Windows 10 when you type iExplore into the run prompt it opens Internet Explorer, in Windows 11 it opens Microsoft Edge. In Windows 11 when you right-click the desktop there is now an option to open the terminal. Windows Terminal does not come with Windows 10 but can be installed. In Windows Terminal you can open Command Prompt, PowerShell and Azure Cloud Shell tabs. In Windows 10 when you hover the mouse over icons on the taskbar there is a square box around them that touches the top and bottom of the taskbar. In Windows 11 there is a rounded box that floats. In Windows 11 when you minimize apps the icon on the taskbar bounces, in Windows 10 it does not. In Windows 11 there are new animations when you minimize, maximize and close windows. Let's compare the boot screen. In Windows 10 we have four solid light blue boxes at an angle. In Windows 11 we have four dark blue boxes not at an angle with a slight gradient. Both have spinning white dots underneath and a black background. Let's compare Windows 11 Leak Build 21996.1 with Windows 11 Insider Preview Build 22000.51. On the left we have Windows 11 Leak Build 21996.1 which was compiled on the 29th of May 2021 and leaked on the 15th of June 2021 and on the right we have Windows 11 Insider Preview Build 22000.51 which was released on the 28th of June 2021. Let's compare the locked screen. In the leak the clock is in the bottom left. In Insider Preview the clock is in the top center. In Insider Preview the icons in the bottom right of the sign-in screen have been updated. In the leak the power options menu has square corners, in Insider Preview it has rounded corners. In the leak the clock shows the weekday in between the date and time, in Insider Preview it only shows the date and time, even though the taskbar is the same height in both. In the leak there is a notification center icon to the right of the date and time, in Insider Preview there is not. In the leak it brings up a pane at the side with notifications at the top and actions at the bottom. In Insider Preview when you click on the clock the notifications are at the top and the calendar is at the bottom and they have rounded corners and float. In Insider Preview when you click the network and volume icons it brings up the actions with a volume slider underneath. In the leak the network and volume icons are separate, in Insider Preview they are combined. In the leak the calendar is square and touches the edges, in Insider Preview it is rounded and floats. In the leak there is an agenda setup below the calendar, in Insider Preview there is not. In the leak there is a glow that follows the mouse in Insider Preview there is not. In the leak when you clear all notifications the notification area is empty. In Insider Preview when you clear all notifications the notification area goes away. In Insider Preview when you hover over search it shows recent searches and when you hover over task view it shows a quick view of the desktops. In the leak it does not. In the leak when you right click the start button the menu has the frosted glass effect, in Insider Preview it does not. In Insider Preview Windows PowerShell has been replaced with Windows Terminal. In Insider Preview the user account control prompt has been updated. Let's compare the settings app. In the leak the icons use flat design, in the Insider Preview the icons use material design. In the leak the main categories are displayed full screen when the settings app is opened and when you click one, the subcategories are displayed down the left with the subcategory contents to the right. In Insider Preview the main categories are displayed down the left and the subcategories within the selected main category to the right. When you click a subcategory the right switches to displaying subcategory contents. In the leak the settings items have square corners, in Insider Preview they have rounded corners. In the leak to switch to a different subcategory within the same main category you click it on the left, in Insider Preview you have to go back to the selected main category and select a different subcategory. In the leak to select a different main category you have to go back to the homepage and then select it. In Insider Preview you select it down the left. In the leak the pane at the left of the settings app is made of frosted glass, in Insider Preview it is not. In Insider Preview you can apply themes to the touch keyboard. In the leak you cannot. Let's compare the File Explorer. In the leak we have the ribbon interface and a file menu, in Insider Preview we have some buttons along the top. In Insider Preview there is a new button that lets you create a new folder or item, in the leak these options are under the new group of the Home tab. In Insider Preview along the top there is Cut, Copy, Paste, Rename, Share and Recycle. In the Leak, Cut, Copy and Paste are under the Clipboard group of the Home tab, and there are also options to Copy Path and Paste Shortcut. Rename and Delete are under the Organize group of the Home tab, and you can either permanently delete or recycle, and you can choose whether to show the recycle confirmation. There are also options to move or copy directly to a folder. In Insider Preview there is a button that brings up a list of sorting options. The common options are there, and there is a submenu for more sorting options. There is also a submenu for Group By. In the Leak, the Sort button is under the Current View group of the View tab, and you can choose more columns. The Group By option is also under the Current View group of the View tab, and there is an option to size all columns to fit. In Insider Preview there is another button to bring up a menu of layout options. It also has Compact View and allows you to show or hide different panes, checkboxes, file extensions or hidden items. In the Leak, the layout options are under the Layout group of the View tab, and it gives you a preview which Insider Preview does not. The options to show and hide panes are under the Panes group of the View tab, and the options to show and hide checkboxes, file extensions and hidden items are under the Show/Hide group of the View tab. In Insider Preview you can enable Compact View in the menu. In the Leak you have to go to the Options dialog. You can also do this in Insider Preview. In Insider Preview there is a button that brings up a menu with Zip, Copy Path, Select Options, Undo, Properties and Options. In the Leak, Zip is under the Send group of the Share tab. Copy Path is under the Clipboard group of the Home tab. Select Options are under the Select group of the Home tab. Properties is under the Open group of the Home tab, and Options is under the View tab. In the Leak there is a quick access toolbar where you can add items from the drop-down menu, and you can also add any item by right-clicking it and clicking Add to quick access toolbar. In Insider Preview there is no quick access toolbar. Let's compare the right-click menu. In Insider Preview, Cut, Copy, Rename, Share and Delete are icons at the top of the menu. In the Leak they are items on the menu. In Insider Preview the menu items are more spaced apart than they are in the Leak. In Insider Preview it says the keyboard shortcuts next to the options. In the Leak it does not. In Insider Preview most of the menu items have icons. In the Leak most do not. In Insider Preview Copy as Path is in the menu. In the Leak you shift right click to get this option. In Insider Preview you can click Show More Options, which brings up the old menu. In Insider Preview the menu that you get when you right click the desktop has also been updated. And you can click Show More Options to bring up the old menu. In the Leak when you right click an icon on the taskbar the menu has square corners and touches the taskbar. In Insider Preview it has rounded corners and floats. In Windows 7 it also has rounded corners and floats. In Windows 8 and 8.1 it has square corners and floats. In Windows 10 it has square corners and touches the taskbar. In the Leak the Ctrl-Alt-Delete screen is the accent color. In Insider Preview the Ctrl-Alt-Delete screen is black. In Insider Preview the store logo has been updated. In the Leak the store is the same as in Windows 10. In Insider Preview the store has been completely redesigned. In the new store the header has a glow that follows the mouse. In the old store the header goes dark. In the old store items have square corners. In the new store items have rounded corners. In the old store there is a frosted glass top bar. In the new store there is not. In the old store there is a search button in the top right. In the new store there is a search bar along the top. In the old store the categories are along the top. In the new store the categories are down the side. In the old store my library is accessed through the menu in the top right. In the new store my library is in the bottom left. Let's compare the widgets dashboard. In Insider Preview it has widgets at the top and a news feed below. In Insider Preview there is an Add Widgets button. In the Leak there is not. In Insider Preview you can change the size of the widgets. You can also remove widgets. In the Insider Preview there is a search bar at the top. In the Leak there is not. Let's compare Windows 11 Insider Preview build 22000.51 with Windows 11 RTM build 22000.194. On the left we have Windows 11 Insider Preview build 22000.51 which was released on the 28th of June 2021 and on the right we have Windows 11 RTM build 22000.194 which was released on the 5th of October 2021. In Insider Preview the circling dots are to the left of the word welcome. In RTM the circling dots are above the word welcome. In RTM there is a search box at the top of the start menu. In Insider Preview there is not. In Insider Preview the taskbar thumbnails have square corners and touch the taskbar. In RTM they have rounded corners and float. In Windows 7 they also have rounded corners and float. In Windows 8.1 they have square corners and float. In Windows 10 they have square corners and touch the taskbar. In RTM there is a chat button on the taskbar. In Insider Preview there is not. In Insider Preview Task View has a darkened background. In RTM Task View has a blurry background. In Insider Preview, the Alt-Tab switcher has a darkened background. In RTM, the Alt-Tab switcher has a blurry background. Let's compare the File Explorer. In RTM, the Sort and View buttons have labels. In Insider Preview, they do not. In RTM, the menu that you get when you right-click the desktop is transparent. In Insider Preview, it is not. Let's compare the Ctrl-Alt-Delete screen. In Insider Preview, the Cancel button is square. In RTM, the Cancel button is rounded. In Insider Preview, there are both Snipping Tool and Snip and Sketch. Snipping Tool is the old one from Windows 7. Snip and Sketch is the new UWP app. In RTM, they have both been combined into a new Snipping Tool. Let's compare MS Paint. In Insider Preview, Paint is the same as in Windows 7. It has a ribbon with Home and View tabs and a File menu. The Home tab contains Clipboard, Image, Tools, Shapes, Size, and Colors. In Windows 11 RTM Paint, there are no tabs. The toolbar at the top is the same as the Home tab but restylized. There is a File menu that is restylized, and a View menu instead of a View tab. In the old Paint, you can customize the Quick Access toolbar. In the new Paint, you cannot. In the old Paint, you can minimize the ribbon. In the new Paint, you cannot. Let's compare the calculator. In Insider Preview, the buttons are square. In RTM, the buttons are rounded. In Insider Preview, the calculator is more transparent than it is in RTM. In Insider Preview, there is a glow that follows the mouse. In RTM, there is not. In RTM, it shows the calculator icon in the top left corner. In Insider Preview, it does not. In Insider Preview, the game bar UI has square corners. In RTM, the game bar UI has rounded corners. Goodbye.